We're trying a slightly different schedule here on Wednesdays at the iOS, mainly because we want to bring in some exciting, talented, fun groups like the first one here tonight. Give your hands some applause.
Anything at all would be super great.
Jesus on a cross.
Jesus on a cross. I'm Christian. Something that is frustrating to me as a believer is that people think that just because I like have faith that I'm also not intellectual or that I can't believe in science when there's really no
reason. I don't like controversy. I'm not a big fan of it. So anytime someone gets me into a debate, I leave. I exit immediately because I cannot argue with anybody, even if it's something I truly believe in.
I ran to the dump last night. It was the first time that it happened. I don't know what to do because he definitely talked back. So now I have to deal with the fact that am I going to do his bidding? Like I said I would. I never break a promise. But I feel like I shouldn't, right? Because God and stuff in the middle ground, the in between. Anyways, I'm going to go to school. Wish me luck.
I don't really like school too much. Sometimes people, they take my books and like, I don't know where my books are. And then the teachers are like, where are your books? And I'm like, I don't know. Someone took it from me. And then they think it was me. They think I was lying the whole time because I don't have my books. But it's the bullies that take my books. And
I've
I don't
know what to do with my books. 20 times because I've been
that is legal. I don't feel
shit.
You
yard and address.
You're rubbing that chair really intensely. It's making me think about boning some more.
If you were gonna bone.
Yeah, bone.
And you were bad, you can read.
Well, my dream, I got slapped with a ruler. It was violent.
On the hands, on the wrists, on the bony parts of your wrist.
Do you want to go out sometime?
Crucifixes! Get your crucifixes here!
Joke, right?
Sometimes the
montage starts at a place where you're not ready for it. But in all honesty, I don't have a ton of friends. So I'm asked to be friends with a 16-year-old.
Cool.
Come, Jen!
Sometimes the chair is the whole reason why your dad left! It's you, chair! It's you! Good dad left! Your chair!
Sometimes the chair is the one that's sneaking in your backyard and sticking up a bunch of holes and putting all your mom's jewelry in the holes!
Fucking chair!
Fucking chair!
You're not a fucking man!
Sometimes it's just the chair's fault that your wife thinks that you're unfaithful because of the way you're sitting in the chair!
Sometimes it goes to America, and no one knows where you're from. you just tried to touch crosses with someone, everyone looks at you weird, or asks for money on the street. I don't know what I'm doing here.
Wait, what's your name for the order?
It's Landon.
Hey, what?
Landon.
I'm sorry, sir. Get the marbles out of your mouth. What's your name for the order?
Landon.
I'm minimum wage. Just tell me your goddamn name. I can't do this, Chuck. I can't do this.
You know, I can put Chuck, and then Chuck will give it to me.
Sorry, sir, what's your name?
Landon. Chuck, it's Land. Chuck, my name's. Chuck, it's Landon. I'm Irish, I've got this.
Chuck, that was so hot that you beat that guy.
I mean, I'm from America. Yeah, you know, what you're saying,
just watch you talk to an American. I appreciate this job.
Seriously, like, you beat him up and then you hired him? I'm just like, I'm a bit more turned on in the workplace.
Really,
what is that?
That's my, that's the chair I worship.
You worship a chair?
Yes, actually.
You're not going to believe this, but I worship a rabbit. Yeah, it's at my house. It's underneath my bed, partially, but also in the center of the room.
Ha!
Don't be. Nothing. mean?
I mean, like, you're putting a copy on things that don't happen.
Everyone told us, like, this is the most important test of our, like, entire lives. It's gonna set us up for, like, everything.
What if you die? Right now? Like, what if you die? Would it be that important? Or would that test you took in third grade where you spelled yellow wrong?
That would be the most important.
I never thought about it that way.
Yeah.
Alright, it's a verbal spelling test. We're gonna throw some lobs out at you first. Go ahead and just spell
any color. You can choose the color.
Well, I choose yellow. Damn it.
Crap. Hear that, class?
Shotgun red.
Right. Tony will give you in a second. Felice, you wanna go ahead and spell your words? And you know everything.
Yellow. Alright. Y.
Good, good start.
E. L. O. Yellow.
Ho ho ho! Tony, you wanna take a shotgun wrist check?
Absolutely.
We take a red or
I'll tell you after everyone's
R. E with a tilde. D. Red.
And who's next?
Johnny.
Purple. Alright. Sharon's got perps. Hit it up.
I can't help but feel like you'd rather be other places. And like, I feel like you're really condescending to the children. And
can people see you or are you in my head?
We can totally see.
Okay, I still am going.
I'd rather get children.
P-U-R-P-L-E.
No, incorrectly.
Why did you come back? It was a good. Why didn't you come home?
Oh my God.
You know, I've been spending quite a lot of time at church.
Keep spelling. Oh, at the church? What are you doing? Praying?
Yeah. Well, there's a big thing now between.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna fight him tonight. Priest versus priest. So you're gonna be in for the long haul. All
right.
I'm psyched. Is he gonna be here or?
Yeah, I'm waiting. I'm waiting for that next priest. But I'm telling you, it's gonna be a long night.
Quiet.
He's gonna get in here any second. This is an Irish accent. He's gonna be in here any second.
I'm stretching.
He's stretching.
No Irish priest comes into my city and thinks he can priest it up. No!
That's what you think.
This little cable.
I'm gonna take my collar off for this one.
I never take mine off.
It's okay if I sit or use. Are these the sacred ones?
In Ireland, we box with obstacles. So feel free to sit wherever you want.
Right, I could do it the Irish way. I could do it that
way. Also, you want to be drunk first.
But that's also an American thing, so let's get on to it.
Yes, Jameson?
Yeah. We got Wild Turkey and we got James.
Walter, Walter, keep your eye on the prize. You're becoming friends.
This isn't bonding. This isn't bonding.
This is a priest thing.
It's a priest thing. Women, right? There you go.
You're from Ireland, that's pretty cool.
Not the time. The two of you booked the sportsman's lounge.
Yeah.
Yes, and then we're gonna fight.
We swear of it, we'll fight.
Oh yeah. But first we wanna lounge.
Yes.
Well, you can lounge in style, okay? Would you like some cigars sent up to your room?
Absolutely.
Yes, cigars, please.
And whiskey.
And a couple's massage.
With hot stones on your back.
Yeah.
Well, let me say, we have a shiatsu, the woman she stands on your back.
Even better.
Okay.
That sounds aggressive, I like it.
Okay.
And we want to be making eye contact the entire time. So if you can make that possible as well.
We will be taking the Bible from the drawer in the room.
Right. We're going to rip the pages out and put it all over our bodies.
If the two of you want to make eye contact so bad, then just make it now. I mean, you're friends, right?
Oh, I've got a new friend.
I kind of.
You want to be friends?
I started to feel a bond, yes.
Oh.
I never wanted to fight you.
You didn't?
I wanted to friend you.
Oh, I thought
love to see a montage of things that the two of you would do as friends, you know? Sure. I don't have a lot of people coming around.
What do you get when you put two priests on a jet ski?
Oh, whole boat of fun!
A good time!
What do you get when you put two priests at a carnival?
Oh, cotton candy? What do you get when you get two priests playing Twister?
Preschool parental. And all of a sudden, the moment became too real. Oh. Yeah, it started getting hot all in their bathing suit areas.
Bathing suit areas, ready to bone.
And I wear a full body bathing suit, and everywhere is hot. Super Irish.
Yo, that's the truth. Yeah. And, like I said, it all started normally with a sword, and then it got into me being a priest.
Yeah, you told it. Okay. That's crazy.
I just thought I'd retell it.
No, we don't need it. That's crazy, though.
Yeah.
I wish I had dreams. I haven't had dreams since my mom died.
Oh. That's really sad.
Is it? I haven't felt since my mom died.
I mean, you know, she's probably sitting in a chair in heaven.
Or in hell, you didn't know her.
I just figured if you were sad about her death, then she must have done something.
Did you hear me? I said I haven't felt since she died. So I don't know if I'm sad, happy, or in between. There is an in between. No one ever talks about it.
Like limbo?
Like limbo, like unsigned, like apathy, like scared, nothing matters.
I mean, there really is an in-between. Like, I believe in chair, but just because I believe in chair doesn't mean I can't, like, sit on a couch.
I believe in chair, but, like, I only go to chair, like, on Christmas or chairs for, like, I don't go all the time, and if my aunt asks me if I go to chair, I go to chair every Sunday.
I don't believe in chair necessarily, but I'm, like, chairy, like, I feel it, and, like, I was born that way, I grew up that way, but, like, I'm not, like, I don't believe in chair, like.
There's no chair. I don't, I don't understand why people keep saying there's no evidence of chair.
I mean, historically, there's a chair!
Well,
I mean, there's a chair in